was delighted to be behind the wheel again, and we reckon we knew what the Leo felt. The further we got up the mine, the more we realized it was a pretty busy river. Everything was going well, until, in a lock in the middle of nowhere, we met with a crisis. The Leo wouldn't move.
What's the matter?
I don't know, there's something wrong. I think the prop's fell off.
The prop?
I think so. Well, I've just checked the shaft. The shaft's turning. I thought it was the company, but it isn't, because look, the engine's turning, and we've got no power off. You can see,
the propeller had fallen off. Ray pushed the Leo with the dinghy until we could get the problem fixed. This carpet on the roof is made of millions of bugs which fly out of the river once a year for a night of passion under the stars, or in this case, our floodlight. I wasn't prepared to see the Leo turned into an entomological bordello. Efficient Germans have these police helicopters patrolling the river looking for pollution and other misdemeanors.
Yes.
Well, you go and see.
Yes, okay.
He's got them there.
Okay.
We'd taken a chance coming up the mine without a pilot, and we both knew that the moment of reckoning had to come. Ray had his story off pat.
Hello?
Yeah, if your papers, please.
Yes.
A certification for the mine?
Well, no. What they are, they're a certification for that I can handle shipping and boats on the Thames. My Thames license. As you can see, it's free of the River Thames, so I can handle boats and tugs, ships on the Thames.
But it's not enough.
Not enough.
You have to have a pilot for the mine before the next stop. You have to stop and go out for a pilot.
Yes.
And then you can go along.
Okay.
We appeared to be under some sort of barge arrest until we got a pilot.
That's good.
And we found him in the local icebreaker captain, who's usually free in the summer.
What's your name?
Gerhard.
Yeah,
Gerhard.
Yeah.
Gerhard.
Good.
Mine is Ray.
Right.
Good.
Nice to meet you, Gerhard.
Okay.
So we can go.
Also, then come on, dann machen wir melden wir Schleuse.
You speak English?
Yeah.
Oh, what's the problem? Yeah, when you come to stand, she always cuts the pole.
Mm. Okay. He won't understand.
He does that. Oh, go on then, you give it to
him.
No, go on then.
Now come up here.
Oh.
That's right, because
it's easy. Oh, yeah.
Now, when he comes back, always this way.
Ah, so. Oh,
yeah. Yeah, this is the living quarters, our living accommodation where we eat, and this is the stove we do the cooking. The freezer's over here, where we freeze.
Ah, cook them all those pizza.
Yeah. And just in here is the two sleeping quarters.
This is a bad, yeah.
Yeah, apart from Tony.
Yeah, well.
Or this is...
Submarines,
yeah, and we got a tank, old big tank, and we pump out as you are, you know. So this is down here, You can see this is a double bedroom, another double bedroom, that's two we've got. And so I say it's quite a good accommodation, yeah.
I think it needs a coat, it's raining, and they used to be all warm, you see, in these
rooms. Well, shouldn't he have brought his own? I mean, if he's any sort of pilot, it's a shovel and a coat.
Well, I think he's going to be, I think he's got better eyesight than old Joseph Webber, I'll tell you on the right now.
I'll give him that.
So, well, we'll give him.
He went there about half hour, he'll running out of it.
They have to wear, it's in the rules that you have to wear a life jacket at all times.
Really?
Yes, sir.
That's our rules, it's very nice.
Europe ship. 105 meters long, 59 meters wide.
The very sight of this Euro ship was enough to justify having Gearhart on board, and besides, he was good company. Next stop was Bamberg, where by chance they were having a beer festival, a uniquely Bavarian event. They left no stein unturned in their search for a good time. There were some other people who looked as though they'd rather be home in bed. The next morning, the lovely old city of Bamberg seemed to be nursing its massive collective hangover. I was aghast at the discovery that the festival was going to go on for another 4 days. This is the town hall perched on piers in the middle of the river, which suggests the importance of the water to the town in the olden days. The citizens recovered faster than I could have believed possible. By mid-morning, they were ready to go at it all over again. The band marched around the town, drumming up support. Water jousting is a Bamberg tradition specially created for the tourist trade. This monk's speciality was silence, a pretty scarce commodity in beer-crazy Bamberg. He explained how monks lived. The order's charter had laid down in the 12th century that the monks were not allowed to own anything bigger than a donkey. This allows them nowadays to own a small family car.
In the city of Bamberg, but therefore it is a new experience for the people finding here a place where it is very silent and where they can sit down for a longer time, some hours or for a weekend, in an atmosphere of silence.
Bamberg is at one end of the old Ludwig Canal, which once linked the Rhine to the Danube. The canal was bombed by the Allies in the war and never rebuilt, too small for Euro shipping. This is Lock 100, the last on the canal, preserved in almost working condition. But the Germans are constructing a vast new waterway to join the Main and the Danube. I asked the manager of the Nuremberg port about it.
I thought Ludwig built a canal.
He also built a canal. It was in the last century, and that canal was terminated. The European watershed is in this direction. Maybe you can see it on the horizon. Probably the horizon is the watershed.
And after that, all the rivers flow the other way.
Yes, that's the Danube, which flows the Black Sea.
This new canal will be about 60 miles long and will connect the Black Sea to the North Sea. A navigation expert explained the politics of the project.
It's no longer the question if it is the most foolish project of the century, as one German Secretary of State used to say, but it would definitely be the most stupid step now of the century if you stopped it. Because all the investment would be lost, and there arise also tremendous legal problems.
At Nuremberg, after following the waterways from London, we finally ran out of water. I hired a firm of German heavy lift specialists to transport us overland to Regensburg, over the European watershed. Once the jewel of the Third Reich, Nuremberg is now a major American Air Force base. When the canal is finished, Nuremberg will be a major inland port as well. Many of the port facilities are already in place. We were happy to take advantage of them. It was the first time the Leo had ever been on a lorry, but it did seem a trifle lacking in dignity. All the same, it was the only way we could reach the Danube, short of sitting there until they finally finished constructing the big canal in 1992. The one thing I was afraid of was the old girl jarring herself to pieces. She was made to ride the gentlest of swells and wasn't equipped for potholes. Her hull repaired over and over again with extra plates on the outside and concrete inside was frighteningly brittle. They had to use two cranes to lift the barge, which had been built in London in 1948, one of the last to be made with rivets throughout. This was the first time I'd ever seen her bottom. It was a great relief that the strops we'd bought from London had been man enough to lift the barge, and that after all the scrapes we'd been through, there were no serious signs of damage to the hull. Getting the load evenly placed was vital. Ray changed the propeller, which had been chipped, and then we discovered a setback.
Can you tell me how much I can have from the deck?
One more good one.
I need to know how much.
Is this deck?
Come here.
10 cm höher, wenn er fährt, ist ja auch wurscht. These are now 3 meters.
3 meters. So I have 1 meter from the deck.
1 meter from the deck, right.
Okay.
4 meters.
Well,
we've got a problem, it's too high.
Everything had to come off the deck to bring it down to the regulation height. And that really meant everything, even if it had to be cut away.
Wait, let's see.
Is it much of a problem to this thing?
If you tell me this thing's
good,
my brain has to wait for the 1400 and then I'm too late, you know.
The lorry driver's pitched in with a will on the job of cutting us down to size. A little Schadenfreude, perhaps.
Arschloch in the midi.
Yep.
When it was done, I took the opportunity to weld up a crack in the rudder. Police finally arrived and meticulously checked the load. Everything was at last in order. Ungainly and out of their element, our two dearly beloved boats lumbered off into the evening. The convoy, which had crossed half Europe, set off in true Wagnerian style. Sometimes I wondered if I'd taken on rather more than I'd bargained for. It had all looked so simple, a question of following a blue line on a map. But I was delighted to see that the Lea had something normally reserved for visiting heads of state and nuclear waste, a real police escort. I brought up the rear in a car with flashing hazard lights, rather hoping that the Leo was absolutely secure. The consequences of a loose hawser at this point didn't bear thinking about. The Germans love fast cars. And the law allows them to go as fast as they like down the freeways or autobahns. I had a feeling, though, that even the hottest rods cooled a little when they saw 42 tons of steel overhanging the fast lane. As we thundered down the autobahn towards the Danube, our excitement knew no bounds. In a few hours, we'd see the legendary river for the first time.